Hi, this is Rich. Welcome to my blog. So let's say a UFO lands in your backyard. What are you going to do? Seriously, what would you do? run like hell. That's always a good option. But let's say you've been working it and you've been wanting to contact a good ET, the friendlies, the ones that are here to help humanity awaken and be free and, you know, be once again part of the galactic community. And so you've been working it. So you're pretty sure that the spacecraft that has landed in your backyard or the back 40 or the woods there near the house, they're the good guys. You can feel it. Okay. Still, same question. What are you going to do? And you go, hi. And let's say you get the introductions over with. Now you're going to interact with these ETs. What are you going to talk about? Are they going to do all the talking? Are they going to be asking you questions and you answering? Are you going to be asking the questions and hope they will answer? Or do you suppose it'll be a mission of some sort? Your own mission. Your job is to tell the world. They're here,
no really, and they're fucking real, man.
And they were in the forest. And I thought, well, people I think have already tried that angle. Over the years, I've talked to quite a few people about this subject. And I've helped people make contact with ETs. Some of them are humanoid and some of them are non-human. The kind of help I do, I help them connect because these ETs are multidimensional or transdimensional. It's easier to make a connect for various reasons. It's easier to connect in the non-physical realms. The physical connection can be a little hard on the body psychologically. We have our subconscious mind can get triggered easily when visitors from outer fucking space land in your backyard. It's like, you may not remember it consciously, but subconsciously, you probably got some past lives where visitors landed in your backyard. And it wasn't so pleasant or friendly. It didn't turn out so well. This happens time and time again. We're very ancient beings. We've done it all. We've probably done it all many times. Repeats. Same sort of things over and over again. So a physical contact is a little more thrilling, you might say, when you're contacting an ET, than if you connect in the astral or in a mutually created holographic or imagined scenario. You create it with your mind, or they can create it with technology, or they can create it with their mind. So yeah, there's these different ways we can make contact. And over the years I've helped people make these kind of contacts. And they've interacted with their ETs. Sometimes they're interacting with the good guys, and sometimes they're facing off the bad guys. And when we are able, we're wide awake in the astral or the fourth density reality or non-physical realm of some sort, and you face it off with them, you look at this reptilian right in the eyes, or this gray, you can communicate with them telepathically, psychically, or verbally, and you can have that discussion you want to make. And because we are so powerful in this other arena, it's like A shark, if you meet a shark in the water, he's going to be ferocious and hard to handle. But you get a shark out on the sand, out of his environment, and now you're dealing with him in the world where you're really able, powerful. It's different. It's going to be a whole different outcome. Likewise, when we are in the astral or non-physical realm, our imagination becomes our power. We can create realms and worlds and environments and weapons and buildings and spacecraft. It's really amazing how powerful we are in these other realms. It's touchy-feely. It's very real. You can see, you know what you're doing. And you can look at these beings, these ETs, directly and have the interaction you want and have that discussion you need to have with them to get them out of your space, get them to quit messing with you. Or if you're talking to the friendlies, you can find out what their mission is, what their history is, what are they doing here, what your relationship with them is. Do you have history with them? Were you one of them before you got born into the physical world? Or are you just a good contact for them? And what can they teach you? What can you teach them? How can you help them? How can they help you? And is this about contribution to humanity? We're trying to help humanity wake up. Or is this about personal development, personal growth? What's it about? What would you do if a UFO landed in your backyard? I know people that have been abducted physically, and I've helped people. This one guy kept having these recurring dreams and out-of-body experiences, and he was pretty sure this was the real deal, connecting with human ETs, spacecraft, part of a fleet in the non-physical realms around Earth. He's over the years. So we got to talking one day, and I said, yeah, I can help you do that. I can help you connect consciously right now. And it's like a guided visualization, but it's more than that. It's different. You're more awake, you're more involved, you're more engaged. And after a little while, it depends on the person. Not everybody can do this, but some people have the ability. Their visual skills are really, really strong. And they can imagine just anything, and it's crystal clear and vivid, 3D holographic, and it's all around them and stuff. So there's a way I can help them bring more of their consciousness into that non-physical realm, and they literally shift consciousness fully enough out of the physical realm to the it is experienced as an out-of-body experience. So then they take it from there. It's no longer guided visualization. It's more like they are now able to interact with their extraterrestrial friends. And this one particular guy, he got on the ship, and he finds that he's part of the officer's crew. So they see him because he's shifted. Now he's on their spacecraft. It's like you're in your astral body or your second body or something. So now he's chatting it up, and he makes contact with his people. And yeah, sure enough, he's there, but he's on mission here. And if a person doesn't work at regaining their memory and regaining their connection with their extraterrestrial or their past life activities, it may not happen. So when people start waking up, or when people start looking up at the stars and they get a yearning for the outer space, the galactic experience, something beyond the physical universe or the Earth experience, you get this yearning. That's a good sign. So just keep doing it. Keep researching. Read up on the different kinds of ETs there are, and the good ones and the bad ones and the neutral and techniques for getting out of body. This is one of the best ways to make contact with your ET buddies. Out of body thing. Oh, and did I mention I have an out of body travel training program over at richwest.net. Yeah. Also, we've made agreements here when we come into this world. We've had to make some limiting agreements so the gatekeepers on this planet wouldn't let us in. So, I agree to not remember my past lives. I agree to not be able to get out of body. I agree to be a schmuck. You know, we make these agreements you got to make. It's like, let's say you're a super being with superpowers, and you want to play around in the metropolis. You want to play around in the city, but the officials say, no, you can't come in here using your X-ray vision and your superpowers. You can't be flying around and shit. You can't do that. You agree not to fly around and shit and not be using your X-ray vision? Then okay. And you go, yeah, okay, no flying, no X-ray vision, got it. So you make the agreement. Now you come in to the world, the realm, the reality system, whatever it is, and you don't use those abilities. And then the sleazy slick suckers say, and forget you made these agreements. Agree to forget and not remember having made these agreements. Okay. So now you agree to forget or agree to not remember. So now you bounce around this world and you get these little vestiges, little vague fragments of memory or a compelling feeling that you have something to do with the extraterrestrials, ETs, and you get this dying in her, I want to make contact with ETs. But you agree not to remember that shit. But you do workarounds. You do everything you can. You know, David Wilcock, Corey Good, different people, quite a few more have these events where you work at contacting ETs. So because I've had some experience with that sort of thing, the contacts with ETs I've made personally have been in the non-physical realms. I haven't been, I don't recall being abducted or making contact in the physical in this life. But I wouldn't be surprised if it happened though. I kind of got creeped out one day when I'm in my 40s and I come and visit my mom. And she's been reading this book by Whitley Strieber, Whitley, about communion. He's communing with the grays. And my mom's reading this book. I'm like, the fuck are you reading that book for? It's like, did she get abducted when I was a little baby in the womb? I'm like, oh, fuck. I knew it. I don't know. Just talking here. That's what I like to do. I like to talk to people. So yeah, over at richwest.net, I have this course, the Soul Contract Revocation course, where you can start spotting these agreements that you made before you got here. And a lot of them were made under deception, deceptive practices of those we made the agreements with. And so we've got a loophole. We can revoke those agreements and regain some of our personal power, our character. These techniques for soul contract revocation also include spotting entities and getting the entities out of your space and retrieving soul fragments and soul essence and energies. There's a lot to it. It's a pretty neat course. There's a lot you get out of it besides just revoking a couple of agreements that you made. In one session, it's not uncommon to find at least 40 or 50 agreements that you've made that you can revoke, and now you no longer have to agree to that as part of your reality. Pretty good stuff. So check it out over at richwest.net if you want. But yeah, contact. If you made, also, if like you're taking a nap and you're having a lucid dream or an out of body experience, and in your out of body experience, spacecraft lands in your backyard. Same question. What are you going to do? Let's make it a given that they're the good guys, okay? Because it's a whole different thing if it's the bad guys. Run like hell. Or face them off. If you know you're in the astral or the non-physical realms, you can, and you have that greater, you're tapped into your greater consciousness and ability, you will have more power to interact and be at cause. But it's complicated. There's lots of different kinds of scenarios. People can be wide awake in the astral and be strapped to a metal table on a spacecraft in the astral. It's more real than here. And you're wide awake and you know exactly what's going on. You look around, you see other beings here and there, other people strapped on tables. There's just a lot going on that they do not want us to know about. So read up on that stuff. Find out whatever other people have experienced, how other people are making contact with ETs, and you decide for yourself whether it's a good idea. And if you have great visual ability, you're very vivid, you know, a vivid imagination. You can imagine a tree and a rock and a house, easy, a pasture and a couple of horses, and it's just like bing, bang, easy. Not everybody can do that, but if you can see it and it's vivid and it just stays there while you watch it and look at it, you can probably do one of these guided sessions that will help you make contact with the real deal ET. Human, non-human, doesn't matter. The good guys, tune into the ones you want to talk to. And you will. This would be probably for people who have already made contact already, like in the dream state or not about experience or just a feeling that they had or they get a vision, things like this. Lots of different ways you can make these contacts. And if you're interested in that sort of thing, put some comments down there. And if I get enough people interested, I might put together another event where I'll take maybe 4 or 5 people. And it'll be a live event, like on a Saturday or morning or something. And on Skype or Zoom or something like that. I explain how it works, and I start guiding you to get in touch with your particular ET, the one or the group that you are interested in contacting. So last time I did it, there was like 5 different people. I'm talking to everybody at the same time. I'm guiding them each at the same time. It's kind of a, you know, it's a generic guiding approach, but each one is zooming in on a specific different ET. I'm basically teaching you how to connect with your ET friends and stuff. Pretty interesting stuff. And then once you learn how to do it, you can do it on your own. You don't need to be guided again. But this, again, this is not for everybody. This is for people with great visualization skills, great high-level ability to imagine and create with the mind. The ETs can meet you halfway, so to speak. You create the environment and they can get into it with you. Or you can mutually create an environment with an ET. But you want to have something to talk about, of course. And anyway. So yeah, I just wanted to make a video. Actually, you can go over to my website, richwest.net. And I have a little thing on the side. Interested in making contact with an ET, and do you have great visualization abilities? If yes and yes, fill out the little form, and if I get enough people interested, I'll do the seminar, we'll just go from there. Something to talk about, yeah. Because I like talking to people. I like talking to you guys. I want to hear about your ET adventures or your urges to connect with ETs. good ETs, dark ETs, reptilians, grays, humans. There's all kinds out there. And unfortunately, the powers that be on this planet do not want us to make contact. They do not want us to know of our galactic history. They want to keep us enslaved and stupid and dumbed down so they can use us, enslave us, and use us in all kinds of ways. That's another video. I'll make that later. But yeah. So once again, thanks for watching. And hope to see you over at richwest.net. Fill out the form if you're into this ET contact thing. And you got great visuals. You might be interested in ET contact and not have great visualization skills. So unfortunately, this is not this particular technique I'm talking about. It's not the one. Anyway. Oh, and yes, I've been on a few spacecraft myself. I made contact several times. And of course, I've talked to many different people in the non-physical realms. Those realms are more real, more touchy-feely than this place ever was or ever will be. So it's a great multidimensional reality out there. So anyway, thanks for watching my stuff. Thanks for commenting. And I will talk to you later, okay? Okay. Bye-bye.